Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. I am Dan Macharia, and I'm excited to share the word of God in this platform. I thank the man of God, Pastor Anthony and Minister Anne, who have given me this chance to share in the word of God. I bless you for the good things that you're doing. I want to share the word of God briefly about giving. And I want to speak about a different kind of giving. We have been used to the kind of giving where you give and expect to be given back. We have a whole group of Christians who have come into this kingdom of God, and they know that every time you give to God, you receive. And in as much as that is true, I want you to understand of a deeper thing in this kingdom of God, where you give and let go. And I want to speak about this giving and let it go. Because this has become a common problem. And I know of many believers who've come to this kingdom and lost it. And they have gone back to the world because they knew that this is the kingdom of just sowing, of just receiving. But today I want to speak about the kingdom of God where you give. When Jesus died on the cross and came back to life, and he bought us by his blood, and we became Christians, a lot of us think that we only share in the power of Jesus Christ. But I want you to understand that we also share in the tribulations that Jesus went through, the accusations, the allegations that were slung against him, and the death. And it is this death of Jesus Christ, him giving his life, that bought us, that made us Christians that we are today. And once you understand the kind of giving that Jesus did, then you begin to understand there are times you need to give to God. And in as much as we know that God lacks in nothing, it is important that you give to God and let it be. That you don't keep asking God that I gave on this particular day. Lord, remember I helped the poor. You don't need to keep reminding God, as it has been the custom for many Christians. I want you to understand of a better way to give. Because our God, in his own time, rewards. And in as much as many of us have come to this kingdom thinking that we are just coming to get a reward, it is important that you give. I want to speak briefly about Mordecai. Mordecai, in the book of Esther chapter 3, and the very last verses of that chapter, it speaks of how Mordecai diffused the plot of two of the king's eunuch to kill him because they were angry. And this he made known to Esther, who indeed made it known to the king. And after investigation, it was found this to be true. And as such, the two men were hung. Now, there was the expectation of Mordecai when he did that. But look at this. When Mordecai saved the king's life, he went back to the gate. He still served at the gate. He went back to his service. He forgot what he did and went back to what he's supposed to do. And even in the beginning of chapter 3 of Esther, the Bible says that after all this was done, after this this plot to kill the king, that immediately King Ahasuerus promoted Haman. And we could expect that he should have been Mordecai being promoted, but it was not as such. But he still went to his gate. The Bible talks of Hannah, who went to God and prayed many prayers, but they all went unanswered. And until the time that Hannah discerned of giving, that she gave a son that she did not have and gave it to God, and she received. And many a times we are fooled that we should only receive from God and not give. In the book of Acts, there was a man called Simon. And when he saw Peter lay hands on people and they got filled with the Holy Spirit, he desired. And actually, he went back to his pocket and pulled some money and wanted to buy this from Peter. But Peter said, "May you perish with your money." And this got me thinking, how many of the things that we make known to the Lord, how many of the seeds that we sow to God perish? Because we give as a shortcut, like Simon tried to do. We give in the expectation that we will bribe our way to the fullness of God's kingdom, to the power of God. That we give not because we are interested in whom God is, but we give because we want to receive. And that got me thinking of many things in the Bible. In the same Acts, there was a lady called Tabitha, also known as Dorcas. And this lady, the Bible describes her that she was full of good deeds and charitable works. And that lady did not expect a thing from a man, because the Bible does not tell us where she sat and asked for something from men. But in her death, the giving that she had given, the charitable works that she had done, redeemed her and brought her back to life. As it was with King Hezekiah, he went to the Lord and said, Lord, if there be a thing that I have done, then give me my life. And he received it. There are times that we ought to do things. We ought to sow in giving to God and never ask for it. Because who knows when the Lord will redeem it for you? Who knows, as it is in the book of Esther 6, that one night the king could not sleep. And when he lost sleep, he asked for the book of remembrance. And behold, the name of Mordecai was there. And it was remembered that Mordecai saved the king's life. Woe would it have been to Mordecai if he sat there and asked the king and prodded him day and night that I saved your life, I saved your life. Because the reward that Haman got was bigger than what he would have asked for. The Bible says that we know not how to pray. And the Bible tells us that God is able to do beyond and above, exceedingly what we ask for. And that begins to tell me that we are short when we ask of God, because we know not of what to ask from God. Why don't you do it? Why don't you give yourself, give your resources, and let it go? And let the Lord who liveth redeem it for you. Brethren, give to God without an expectation that he will give back. Indeed, he's a God who gives. But give to this God who gave his son to die on the cross for you. Give your life, give your blood and sweat, your effort and energy to a God who bought you from the devil. To a God who lost, seemingly, his son for you. Give and let go. I want to pray with us that have been lost in the gospel of sowing and sowing and sowing. And indeed, it's right to sow. But it's also proper that you give yourself. A gospel where you've been told that you only harvest. Father, in the name of Jesus, touch these hearts and these men that they may know the true ways of God. And they may carry your cross, for your cross is light. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Thank you. Shalom, and God bless you. Amen.